I'm the highest in the room. Hope I make it out of here. We ain't stressing about the loot. My block made a case of real. This not the molly, this the boot. Ain't no coming back from here. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to another edition of Diamond and the Rough Sports Talk. For today's special guest, we have the All-American, the number 13 ranked player in the class of 2023, Newman starting point guard, Mr. Chris Lockett. Welcome to the show.
Thank y'all for having me.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So, man, just to start off, tell us how you and your family are holding up thus far during this pandemic.
It definitely brought us together, and, like, we just been working, like, to see how I'm going to get in the gym and how, like, the classes. I'm going to take my classes for this upcoming school year.
Definitely. Now, one of the things that I appreciate about your game thus far, you know, you're going to be entering as a sophomore, is your IQ for the game. You know, for instance, when you drive into the hole, you know, and the center slides over for help, you stop and either you hit the floater or you hit the jump shot. Is there a certain coach that has helped you with this, or was this always just natural in your game?
It's like, it was always natural. It's like, for instance, like, if you touch a stove and it's hot and you just hurt and just, like, dish it off or something like that. Right. So, it's just definitely, like, you just read the defense before it happened, basically.
Right. You know, as I mentioned earlier, you know, there's some seniors who don't get that concept. You know, so the fact that you get that concept at an early age is special.
Thank you.
Now, you can score the basketball at all three levels. But one of the things is your post game. Man, it's sick. You know, you're a bigger guard. So just talk to us about at about, what are you, 6'5"?
Yeah.
Okay. So just tell us, how big of a mismatch are you for guards, you know, being that you can take them in a post and do your different scoring actions from that?
I mean, it's definitely, like, fun doing that because, like, they really can't stop me. So it's just, like, if they double-team me, somebody open. If they don't, I'm going to score the ball.
Definitely. You know, you being a point guard, that's what you want on the double team. You know, easy assist.
Yeah. Yeah.
Definitely. Now, you also have a teammate by the name of Javon Ruffin, who's also a D1 caliber player as well. Tell us what it's like to play with him, and do you personally feel as if you guys are the best duo in the state?
It's fun because, like, in practice, we both go at it. Like, we talk trash, so it makes us both better. Mm-hmm. And I feel like we're not even the best dude. Like, my team is personal. Like, we're the best team in the state, basically, right. Besides that.
Right. Yes, sir. So, you know, being ranked in the country, as I mentioned, you're the number 13 overall player. Do you feel as if it's a target on your back every time you step on the floor?
For, like, this past, like, freshman year, I had a target on my back, like, the whole year. So, it really ain't nothing new to me at all.
Definitely. Just makes things more interesting for you, right? Makes you just want to go out and ball that much more.
Yeah.
Right. So tell us about your AAU team. You know, who is it that you play for, and what is the experience like with AAU basketball, and how would you say it's different from high school basketball?
I play with Houston Hoops, known for producing young NBA stars like Tyrese Maxey, the upcoming draft. Wow. De'Aaron Fox, such guys like that.
Definitely.
And, like, the difference between high school and, like, EYBL, that's what I'm planning on next year, it's, like, it's more hype, and, like, we get to, like, show, like, we get to play against top talent. Like, we can't hide from that, basically.
Right.
Just like high school.
Definitely. So tell us about your head coach at Newman, Mr. Randy Livingston. You know, he was in his class – he was the number one player coming out as well. Just talk about tell us what it's like to get coached by someone of that caliber who also competed in the NBA as well.
I mean, it's awesome because, like, he, like, helped me with my weaknesses and, like, also, like, helped me with my strengths and, like, get it better. So he just tell me, like, focus on school and all the rest of the stuff is going to happen for you. So he just tell me what to look out for, like, on the court and life, period, and, like, what to see in, like, college coaches. Yeah.
Definitely. So for those of us who haven't seen you play, for the people who haven't seen you play, you know, obviously me and Kendell have seen you play numerous times. You know, but for those, the people who haven't seen you, is there an NBA player comparison who you model your game at and who you say your game is sort of similar like?
I try to play like a lot of people. I get a lot of things from different players like Penny Hardaway, Kevin Durant, who else did I have? Steve Nash, Kobe, LeBron, Kyrie. It's like some guys like that. But like the person I watch the most like right now is probably Josh Christopher that's going to Arizona State.
Right. Oh yeah. Jacob, huh?
Yeah.
Oh man. He a dog. You know, I know you mentioned Penny Hardaway earlier. Just talk about, tell us what it was like to receive an offer from Memphis.
It was like special because like the last game they played against Tulane, I got a chance to meet him. Mm-hmm. And we were just talking. And, like, he said he really loved my game. And, like, I really didn't get a chance to talk to him because, like, they got legal things. Like, yeah, I don't want them to get in trouble or nothing. Yeah. So we just had to make it fast. So I feel like it was special. And, like, they one of my top schools.
Right. For sure. Now, man, I got a little situation of basketball for you. Mm-hmm. You know, so it's 8 seconds left in the game. Your team is down by two. Do you feel as if it's on you to score at that point, or do you kind of take a LeBron approach and just try to make the best basketball play, whether that be you scoring or dishing it off to a teammate?
I'm scoring. I got you. I'm scoring. Yeah. I got you.
That's right, man. I appreciate that, man. I respect that, man. I appreciate you bringing honesty to the show, man. I really do appreciate that, man, because, you know, some people would be like, oh, I'll do this, I'll do that. Nah, you telling that, bro. Hey, that's facts, my brother. That's all the questions I have for you. You know, that'll be the floor, is not you.
Hey, what's up, Chris?
What's up?
From watching your film, when I seen you in a pose with the ball in your hand, you have a very, very, very vicious step back, fadeaway. Mm-hmm. What age did you develop that skill? How much time do you spend working on it? Because it really does remind me of Kevin Durant.
I started working on it in 4th or 5th grade, because like my dad took me to the Tulane facility, and he used to like tell me work on like my 1 foot jumper. Like he used to have me shoot with 1 foot, and then that's when I just started developing like some more like 6th or 7th grade, like back to the basket, then just separation basically.
Because man, you know, your game ain't nothing forced about your game. Your game is smooth. You know, I watch you break your opponents down. You know, you're pretty advanced for your age. You know, you're very advanced. What age, speaking of your age, what age did you first pick up a basketball? And when did you realize your basketball skills can take you far in life?
I picked up basketball like I was 4. And like when I realized I could like do something good, that's when I like first got ranked, I think like 3rd or 4th grade.
How did that moment make you feel, if you can recall?
When I first got ranked?
Yeah, you know. How did that moment make you feel?
Wait, back then or right now? It's like it's two different perspectives. I mean, I was happy because I was young and like nobody knew me, and it felt like at first I felt like I was like the first player to get top 10 like in a state ever. So it was like a happy moment, but like right now, I'm like, I feel like I got disrespected in ESPN rankings because like, I feel like none of the ESPN people like never watch my game. They just going off what they see off highlights. I can like speak for like everybody in that class, but like just for me, I just brought another. It made me feel like I'm a dog now. Like I feel like anger now.
So since you said that, control my next question. I remember, first of all, rest in peace, Kobe Bryant.
Yeah.
For my next question is, before Kobe, on his last interview, somebody asked him, did he have a hit list to be the number one player in America? He said, sure he did. And he revealed that hit list. So I'm asking you, Chris, do you have a hit list to be the number one player in America?
Oh, of course. Yeah. I watched everybody in front of me. Like, since the ESPN rankings dropped, I watched everybody in front of me. Like, I watched all the games, like, to see what they have better than me, and like none of them impressed me except probably DJ Wag. That's it.
So this is that the only person that's on your hit list, the DJ that you wanna beat, or Is there other people you don't want to say their name, or do you mind?
They got, they have a lot. They got more people. They got DJ Wag, Mikey Williams, Jalen Lewis, Bay Falls, Simeon Williter. They got Juan. They got Tyler Smith. They got, what else they have? They got some people behind me I want to play too. Isaiah Collier, Callan Charlier. I can keep going. They got more people, but that's my play.
Ronnie is too, huh?
Yeah, but like, I really don't, like, it's set in stone. Like, I know I'm better than him.
Yes, sir.
How much time do you spend working on shooting free throws?
A lot of time. Like, that's like one of the downfalls I had this season. That's something to get. We lost so much to free throws. It's
Something had happened. Can you repeat it again?
I said I could put the blame on myself for like us losing games because I miss a lot of free throws. So like that's what I've been working on this whole quarantine, like getting stronger and just shooting free throws and working on my 3-point.
Straight up, putting all the work in.
Yeah.
Can you please tell the world what basketball camps and events you plan on to attend while currently still in high school?
Jeez. They got the NB. It's something. The top 100 camp, the USA camp. Of course, I went to that. The NBAP, something like that. It's top 100, like, for UIBL. It's, like, a lot of camps, honestly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are you seeking to break any records while attending Newman High School?
I'm really not focused on that because if I just play my game, I know I will break them. So I really don't set no goals. So.
What are you looking forward to? What are your goals to achieve within the next 3 years?
Oh, coming out of high school, being the number one player, being an All-American, McDonald's All-American, John Bryan, playing on the Team USA, World Team, winning Nasmith Player of the Year, Gatorade Player of the Year, Gatorade Player of the State. Y'all get me?
Yeah, it clicked off again. There you go. It clicked off again.
Hold up, bro. Y'all can hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
I'm out of. Yeah. Hold on. Yeah, hello?
Yeah, since the camera come off, I'm gonna ask you that question again.
Okay.
What are your goals to achieve within the next 3 years while attending high school?
Winning the state championship for the next 3 years. Winning Nasmith Player of the Year one of these years. Gatorade Player of the Year one of these years. Winning Gatorade Player for the state the next 3 years. Coming out of high school, being a number one player, McDonald's All-American, Jordan Brand, All-American, Team USA, select to play against the world team. And that's it.
What are some of your hobbies outside of basketball?
That's nothing. I just play the game and just hoop.
You be on that 2K?
I got 2K, yeah, I'll be on Call of Duty. Yeah, all that, Madden.
For my last question, what is your burning desire?
Sir?
What is your burning desire?
Can you get, like, perspective, right? Like, I don't know what you mean by that. Like,
what's in your What do you truly want to achieve in your heart? What's burning so much in your heart that you want to achieve?
Be the number one. I mean, make it to the NBA, be the best player to ever play the game, honestly. That's how I like look at it.
Great answer.
Yeah. Well, can you tell us your social media platform so the people who view this would be able to follow you and keep up with your journey?
My Instagram is @Chris2. My Twitter is @Chris2. And my Snapchat is @Chris2. And my gamer tag is @Chris2.
Yes, sir. Well, man, we definitely thank you for taking the time out of your day and spending it with Diamond in the Rough, man. We really appreciate that.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, sir. And ladies and gentlemen, with that being said, to conclude episode 42 with Mr. All-American himself, Mr. Chris Lockett. Thank you.